Okay, here we go. Video number two. So we just talked about these dot diagrams for individual atoms. Okay, what we're going to be talking about and what's more important is the dot diagrams for molecules when we have atoms bonded together, whether it's covalent or ionic. We need to know what happens to these electrons, the electrons that we've documented here in our dot structures, when we bond together. Okay? So there's a thing called the octet rule. Okay? And the octet rule is kind of what it sounds. Oct means eight, right? Octopus, octagon, eight. So when things bond, they need eight electrons in their valence, what's called the valence shell, or their outermost electrons have to number eight. Okay? These energy levels, when they are full, they are stable. And that's what we want. That's why things bond, is to become more stable. Okay? The noble gases, all the way over on the far right-hand side of that periodic table, they already have eight valence electrons. That's why they don't bond with anything, because they don't need to. They're already stable. They're already full. Okay? So the octet rule is that when things bond, they want eight electrons in their valence shell. Okay? So here is just a quick rundown for ionic bonding. Okay, we talked about the single electron being transferred over. Okay, and that switching, and here it's still depicted as red to tell you that this is the electron that came from sodium. Okay, so we're transferring electrons from the cation to the anion, and then that opposite charge attracts. Okay. Covalent bonding is different. Remember that we share electrons now. And so this hydrogen goes right there. And this hydrogen comes over right there. And now we share these electrons. H and H and O form H2O, which is water, which is a covalent molecule. Okay? So, what we're looking at here is that two dots between the atoms represent a chemical bond. And so, this right here represents a bond, and this right here represents a bond. Okay? That's important. We need to understand that as we move forward. Pause the video. I want you to write these down. Okay? You pause and write. When you come back, I'll talk about them. Okay? So, our first rule, we have five steps to drawing these Lewis dot structures. And the first one is to count up the total number of valence electrons for the whole molecule. Okay, so if you have four different atoms, you need to look at your periodic table, count up the valence electrons for each one, and there's your total. Okay, you're going to look for the central atom. So, we're on to step number two. Central atom goes first. And then everything else goes around it. Okay? Sometimes it's going to be easy to figure out which one's the central atom. Sometimes it's going to be a little bit difficult. But for your purposes, I'll make sure to identify which one is the central atom. Okay? So that one goes in the middle, and everything else goes around it. If there's two things, put them on the left and the right, or the top and the bottom. If there's three things, put them on the left, the right, and the top, or the top, the bottom, and the right, however you want to do it. Okay? Next, you put two dots between the central atom and all of the other atoms. Okay? That's going to be your chemical bond. You bond those two atoms together. Okay? So that's step number three. Step number four is to place eight electrons. Remember, that's our octet number. So eight electrons around the outer atoms if needed. Okay? Remember that hydrogen only wants two, because it's small and it doesn't go all the way up to eight. Okay, so hydrogen only needs two. Everything else needs eight. So if they don't already have eight, then you put your dots in there to number it up to eight. Okay. After step number four, we're going to count our dots. We're going to count the electrons and see if that number matches the number from number one. Okay, our total number of valence electrons. If it's equal and everything has 8 electrons, we're good. Okay? If it's not equal, or we don't have enough, we need to place the remaining dots on the central atom. So the central atom gets the remaining electrons. If we have too many electrons, if we count them up and we have too many in our diagram, and we need to figure out how to take some out, we're going to do what's called a double bond or a triple bond. And we'll talk about that here in a sec. And we'll have an example of that as well. Okay, so we're going to look for the potential to have a double bond or a triple bond. This is a structural formula that uses the dashes in between molecules to show a bond. So a normal way, and these are double bonds right here, okay, but a normal Lewis dot structure would have carbon, oxygen, and oxygen, and if we did it real quick, it would look like this, where we have two sets of shared electrons between carbon and oxygen. That's a double bond, okay? An easier way to write this is just with two dashes in between. So one dash would represent a single bond, two dashes represents a double bond, and three dashes represents a triple bond, okay? So we have single bonds, double bonds, triple bonds. Whoa, is that going to time out on me every time? Hopefully not. So single bonds are the weakest covalent bond. Triple bonds are the strongest covalent bond, and double bonds are somewhere in the middle. The things that you probably need to know most are how many electrons are shared between each bond. Okay, so a single bond shares two electrons, one from this atom, one from that atom. A double bond is going to share two from this one and two from this one, so a total of four. And a triple bond shares three from each, a total of six. Okay? Now let's get into what we're really looking for. All right, drawing these Lewis structures. So we have CF4. Carbon tetrafluoride is what this is. So this is a pretty easy one to identify your central atom. Okay, if you have four of the fluorines, that is probably not going to be your central. You have one, so that's your central, is carbon. And so we're going to put F, 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 and F around. We need to total up our valence electrons. So we get four from carbon. We get seven from fluorine, but we have to multiply this by four because we have four of them. Okay, so we have 4 plus 28 is equal to 32. All right, I'm going to do this representing our dots. So remember, step three is now putting two dots in between the central atom and everything else. Step four is to fill in the outer elements, or the outer atoms, with a full octet. So I'm going to add in, I already have my two over here, then there's 4, 6, and 8 for each element, or for each atom. Okay, then step five is to count and see if we have enough. We need to total up 32 electrons here. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32. Bingo, this would be our, and I'll just put it up here. This would be our Lewis dot structure for CF4. Okay? This next one I want you to try and do on your own. Remember, total up the dots, total up your valence electrons, fill in your dots accordingly, put them around the central atom first, and then fill in your eight, and then count them up and see if you have the same number. So you got OF2 and oxygen is going to be your central. So I want you to pause the video and try to do this one on your own. Okay, so now you're back. Oxygen has 6. Fluorine has 7 times 2, so that's 14 plus 6 is 20. Okay, so we have 20 valence electrons. We have O in the middle and F around. We're going to put two dots in between the Fs and the O to represent our chemical bond. Then we're going to fill in our outermost with 8. Okay, and now we count. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. We don't have 20 yet. But remember that octet rule. Every element wants to have 8 electrons when it's bonded. Right now, oxygen only has 4, 2 here and 2 here. And it has 2 open spaces that we can put in 2 electrons right there. Bada bing, bada boom, let's count them up again. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Now we are good to go. So this is your dot structure for OF2. All right. Let's do one more together. This one's a little tricky. You can pause it and try to do this one on your own. If you want to, great. If not, just follow along. So we have SiO2. Oxygen has 6. That's going to be times 2. Silicone is right below carbon. It's going to have 4. Okay, so we have 6 times 2 is 12 plus 4 is 16. Silicone is going to be your central atom. Oxygen is around the outside. We're going to put our bonds here in the middle, and we're going to fill in our valence around the outermost electrons. But and if we counted these, we have 16, right? We have 8 around the oxygen, 8 around the oxygen. But we only have 4 around the silicone, okay? So this is when we don't have enough. If we go back to rule number 5, if we don't have enough, we have to move things and get some triple, maybe double bonds somewhere in here, okay? So if we were to fill in our octet, we would have too many. Okay, so we want to take these out. Actually, I'm going to leave these in here for just illustrative purposes. I want to move a pair. I want to kind of consolidate these. Okay, so I'm going to take these two pairs and I'm going to move them here in the middle. All right, so what that's going to look like, if I erase my doodles, I'm going to take them and go here and take them away from there. Okay, so if I count them now I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. So I reduced my number by 2 by creating that double bond. So I'm going to do it again, and I'm going to look at this pair and move them to the middle in here. Okay, and so I'm going to take that one out, and put them right here. Move that arrow. Now I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, which is right. Now I got to count up and make sure everything's got 8. Okay, so oxygen here around here, we got 2, 4, 6, 8. Silicone, my electrons here, 2, 4, 6, 8. Got it, good. And oxygen, 2, 4, 6, 8. Everything is satisfied by the octet rule, and we are good to go. I got 30 seconds left on this video. Another way to write this is in that structural formula where we replace the bonding electrons with just a bar. Okay, so if you like the dots, use the dots. If you like the bars, use the bars. Cool. 10 seconds. I'll see you guys. We're going to go over a couple of questions on that homework sheet. All right? Peace.